Good morning, all of you. Today's session is for class 7, chapter number 3, page number 311, synopsis 3. And it is the one of colligative property, that is elevation of boiling point. First of all, what is the definition of boiling point? The temperature point at which the liquid converts into vapor. Liquid converts into vapor. The temperature point is known as boiling point. For example, the boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. In terms of Kelvin, 373 Kelvin. In terms of Fahrenheit, 212 Fahrenheit. Now, what is the another definition of a boiling point? The molecules of liquid are in equilibrium condition with the molecules of vapor. Hence, at that condition, vapor pressure of liquid is equal to atmospheric pressure. Then, hence, that point is known as boiling point. Now, what is the definition of elevation of boiling point? When a non-volatile solute is added to the volatile solvent, hence, the increase in boiling point is known as elevation of boiling point. Elevation of boiling point. It is also known as ebullioscopy. While taking the graphical representation between vapor pressure and its temperature, vapor pressure is considered on the y-axis and the temperature considered on x-axis. Now, for this solvent, the vapor pressure given as the curve A and B. The vapor pressure of a pure solvent is always less than that of a vapor pressure of solution. And the solution vapor pressure curve given as C and D. The point at which the vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. Vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. For that solvent, it is known as a boiling point of a pure solvent, and the point at which for the solution is known as a boiling point of solution. The difference between the boiling point of a solvent and a solution is given by delta TB. Delta TB equal to TB minus T naught of B. Actually, delta TB is directly proportional to M. Delta TB is directly proportional to M. It can be proved by delta TB is directly proportional to delta P, change in pressure. Now here, delta P directly proportional to chi S, mole fraction of solute. While combining these two, we'll get delta TB is directly proportional to chi S. While eliminating proportionality, delta TB equal to K into chi S. Chi S, mole fraction of solute, that can be written as delta TB equal to K into NS by N0, number of moles of solute by number of moles of pure solvent. NS, number of moles of solute, N0, number of moles of pure solvent. Then from this one, delta TB equal to K into number of moles of solute by weight by gram molecular weight of pure solvent. Then from this one we can write delta TB equal to K into M1 into N1 by W. The product of constant into M1 is given as KB into number of moles of solute by mass of solvent. If W equal to, if in case W equal to 1000 grams, nothing but 1 kg, then N1 by W gives as the M, molality. M represents your molality in terms of number of moles per kg. Then from this relation we will get the delta TB is directly proportional to M. Mathematically it can be proved like this. Delta TB directly proportional to M. And whereas here molality is given by molality. What is the purpose of molality? In the calculation of molecular mass of solute. The solute is non-volatile. Solute is non-volatile. While calculating volatility, A by M, A. Now here A represents the weight of a solute. A represents weight of solute. Now M represents a molecular weight of solute. Molecular weight of solute. Now B by W. B by W. Nothing but that molality is regarding to the mole fraction. That is chi S. From this one, chi S equal to A by M into W by B. Now here B represents weight of solvent, weight of solvent, and the W represents molecular weight of solvent, molecular weight of solvent. Now whereas here delta TB equal to TB minus T naught of B. TB represents a boiling point of solution, T naught of B represents a boiling point of pure solvent. And now T naught of B equal to R T naught square by delta HV into chi S. Delta HV. Now here delta HV represents latent heat of vaporization. Latent heat of vaporization. Delta HV. Latent heat of vaporization. Nothing but the amount of energy required to convert 1 kg of liquid totally into the vapor form. Then that energy required is known as latent heat of fusion. And the chi S represents mole fraction of solute. From this one, it can be written as delta TB equal to R T naught square by delta HV into chi S value A by M into W by B. And whereas here delta HV equal to LV into W. LV into W. LV represents latent heat of vaporization. Now here heat enthalpy. Heat enthalpy. And now W represents molecular weight of solvent. While submitting the above value, delta TV equal to R T naught square by delta H LV into W into A by M into W by B. W and W make it cancel each other. And now here A by M equal to 1 mole of solute. A by M considered as equal to unity, that is 1 mole of solute. And B weight of solvent, nothing but 1 kg, that equal to how many grams? 100 grams. Then the above equation becomes delta TB equal to R T naught square by LV into 1 into 1 by 1000. Now from this one, that LV equal to delta HV by M1. Delta HV by M1. Now here that M1 represents molecular weight of solvent. Now when submitting the above value, then delta TV equal to R T naught square by delta HV into M1 by 1000. The above equation given as delta TV, elevation of boiling point. Elevation of boiling point can also be called as ebullioscopy. Ebullioscopy. And KB represents, now here the KB represented as elevation, ebullioscopic constant or a cryoscopic constant. Cryoscopic constant. Now coming to the table that regarding to cryoscopic constants. Volatile solvents. What are the different types of volatile solvents we are taking here? Volatile solvents, acetic acid. Its molecular formula is CH3COOH. And our second one is cyclohexane. cyclohexane C6H12 cyclohexane. Now from this one, third one is benzene. It is also one of the non-polar solvent and it is highly volatile, C6H6. And fourth one is carbon tetrachloride, carbon tetrachloride or tetrachloromethane, CCl4. And fifth one is water, one of the polar solvent, water. Its molecular formula is H2O. Water molecular formula is H2O. And now coming to sixth one, chloroform. Chloroform CHCl3. Its IUPAC name is trichloromethane. Trichloromethane. And next one, carbon disulfide. Carbon disulfide. It is one of the non-polar solvent and it is highly volatile, CS2. Coming to eighth one, diethyl ether or ethoxyethane, C2H5O, C2H5, ethoxyethane. And one more is here, ethanol. Ethanol is miscible with water, C2H5OH, ethanol. Now coming to freezing point in terms of Kelvin, top to bottom it is going to get increases. It is going to get increases. Now constant KB in terms of kilo kg per mole. This one also top to bottom going to get increases. Going to get increases. Freezing point completed. Now boiling point. Boiling point also top to bottom going to get increases. Freezing point represented by KF and boiling point represented by KB. KB also same units in terms of kilo kg per mole. This value also top to bottom going to get increases. All the values from top to bottom going to get increases. Now in this session we discussed the elevation of boiling point and the calculation of molecular mass of solid. Thanks for watching.